The dawn of the 20th century was a time of great innovation in America. The age of the automobile was underway, electricity illuminated the nation's streets, and moving pictures were a curiosity. Empowered by a climate that supported progress and originality, American architects also sought a vision for the future. Experimenting with new materials and technologies, and exploring avenues of design beyond traditional European styles. With its progressive ideals and booming economy, the city of Chicago became the perfect stage for an American architecture for the new century. The revolution that ignited in the Midwest began with the Chicago architect Louis Sullivan. For Sullivan, the great architectural styles of the past had been created by architects and craftsmen in tune with the world around them. Their buildings were a product of their specific time and place. In his writings, Sullivan advocated for an honest architecture, reflecting the Midwestern landscape and suited to a modern America. He applied these ideals to tall office buildings and large commercial structures, such as Chicago's Auditorium Theater. Sullivan's vision for an indigenous American architecture inspired the young men employed in his office. The most significant of these individuals was Frank Lloyd Wright, who joined Sullivan's office as a draftsman in 1888. A bold and visionary architectural designer, Wright developed a unique vocabulary of space, form, and pattern that represented a remarkable shift in design from the traditional houses of the day. Characterized by dramatic horizontal lines and masses, open floor plans, and light-filled interiors, Wright's prairie buildings that emerged in the first decade of the 20th century heralded a new era in architecture and design. During his early years, Wright's work was supported and often enhanced by a group of pioneering Midwestern architects at work in and around Chicago. The work of George Elmsley and William Gray Purcell, George Washington Mayer, Dwight Perkins, and many others contributed to the development of the prairie style. While each architect brought their own distinct voice and vision to their work, the buildings of the Prairie School share a common vocabulary of design, a harmony between architecture and nature, an inherent belief in the natural qualities of building materials, the opening up of interior living spaces, and a strong sense of unity in all elements of a building's design. The work of the Prairie School architects would leave an indelible mark on the architectural landscape of the Midwest. In 1898, Frank Lloyd Wright opened his architectural studio in Oak Park, a quiet, semi-rural village on the western edges of Chicago. Drawn to the studio by Wright's design vision were a group of talented young draftsmen, architects, and artists, all of whom would contribute to the legacy of the Prairie School. Key members of the studio included Marion Marney, the first practicing woman architect in Illinois, Walter Burley Griffin, William Drummond, Barry Byrne, and the artists Richard Bock and George Mann Nedekin. The individuals who worked for Wright came to the studio with varying degrees of experience. During the early years of business, the principal staff members, Marney, Griffin, and Drummond, were academically trained and professionally licensed architects. These skilled practitioners were instrumental to Wright as he worked to master his vision for a new American architecture. Despite their varied backgrounds, Wright's staff was united ideologically. They were strongly influenced by the principles of the British Arts and Crafts movement. They shared a reverence for the natural world. They were inspired by the teachings of Wright's mentor, Louis Sullivan. But above all, they shared Wright's desire to create a new, democratic architecture, free from historic European styles and designed for the contemporary American lifestyle. Working in Wright's drafting room was a life-changing experience for his staff. After leaving his employ, the individuals who worked at the studio would play a critical role in the dissemination of the Prairie style of architecture. While many of Wright's former staff forged successful independent careers both locally and nationally, it was Marion Marney and her husband Walter Burley Griffin whose creative vision was most expansive. Married in 1911, the couple would leave an impressive body of work on three continents. With projects ranging in scale from furniture and decorative arts to the design of entire towns and cities, their careers would take them far from the Midwest prairie, with built work in Australia and India. In his later career, Barry Byrne, who joined Wright's office in 1902 as an inexperienced novice, would increasingly focus on ecclesiastical and educational architecture. Byrne became the only architect of the Prairie School to build in Europe. His modernist Church of Christ the King, built in Ireland in 1931, is a landmark in ecclesiastical design. Wright himself continued to explore the concept of organic architecture, first defined during his Chicago years, but would seek new influences beyond that of the Midwest prairie. Wright's singular artistic vision set him apart from his Prairie School contemporaries. His capacity for innovation and invention would shape the course of 20th century architecture and design, resulting in some of the most iconic structures of the modern era. The Prairie School itself would not survive the second decade of the 20th century. In the wake of the First World War, an intense wave of conservatism swept the country, signaling a change in taste away from the values of the Prairie School. Today, the buildings of the Prairie School can be found across the Midwest. Instantly recognizable, they stand as an enduring testament to the progressive spirit of the region, a powerful legacy of design that marked a decisive step forward into the modern era.